The problem in Champaran is associated with indigo cultivation. Indigo cultivation. Indigo is a cash crop introduced by the British during the mid of the 19th century. Mid of the 19th century. Cash crop. Introduced by the British in the mid of the 19th century. And this indigo was cultivated based on a system which is called the Teen Katia system. Teen Katia system. 3 by 20th. Teen Katia. Which means every peasant or farmer compulsorily he has to cultivate 3 by 20th of his land or 3 by 20th of his land for the cultivation of indigo. Compulsory. And that 3 by 20th is normally the best part of the land. Sir, because of this, what happens? Because of this, the British planter, he benefits because of the cultivation of the indigo. The peasant is given just meager income. Contract farming had been introduced. Meager income was given. While the British planter gains by the high prices in the international market for indigo, while he gains by the high prices of the international market for indigo, the Indian peasant suffers because the land which is used for cultivation of indigo becomes barren in a short duration of time. So he suffers. And this continued for many years, for more than 50-60 years it continued. In Deccan also there was an indigo revolution. Indigo revolt we say. 1860s, Deccan Indigo Revolt, where the peasants opposed the indigo planters. But the scenario changed in 1900s when an artificial dye which is called a VAT dye was introduced in Germany. VAT dye was introduced. The introduction of the VAT dye reduced the demand of indigo in the world market. I am speaking as if I am writing an answer. I am not speaking now as if I am speaking in a class. So the introduction of VAT dye reduced the demand of indigo in the global market. So the indigo planters suffered losses. And the indigo planters asked the Indian peasants to compensate the losses suffered by them. And they collected money. You understand? They said that we are suffering, so you have to pay. So most of the indigo planters in many places in the northern part of India, they asked the peasants to compensate their losses which they suffered. And in Champaran, the problem was very acute. There is a person who is called Rajkumar Shukla. So the Rajkumar Shukla asked Gandhi to come to Champaran and investigate into the problem of indigo cultivation and give them a solution. Gandhi came to Champaran in 1917 and properly studied the genesis of the problem of the indigo cultivation. Gandhi identified that the British planter had wronged, exploited the indigo cultivating peasants. The British planter had wronged and exploited the peasants. And he says that it is not the peasants who have to give compensation to the indigo planter, but in return the indigo planter has to give whatever compensation he has taken from the peasants back to them he has to give. Already some compensation had been taken by the indigo planter, that has to be returned back. Now later the British government appointed a committee in which Gandhi was made a member. And after proper discussion, the committee said that the indigo planter has to give the money back to the peasants. It is a great success because the verdict is in favor of the peasants. And because of this humiliation, indigo planters vacated India and left for Britain, which is good for everyone. Indigo planters, they could only exploit as long as the peasants could be exploited. Now when the verdict is passed in favor of the peasants, by the government, the Indigo planter felt that their time period in India is over. So most of the planters, they closed their small industries, whatever they had, they left forever. This is the issue in Champaran. It is one of the successful movements, the first movement of Gandhi in India. This is called Champaran Satyagraha or Champaran movement.